So first of all, by default, Gmail has the inbox separated into multiple inboxes. So let's quickly change this so we only have one inbox in Gmail. So we're going to go up to the top right corner and click on the gear icon. And then from here, we're going to make sure that default inbox type is selected. But then we're going to click on customize. And from here, we're going to uncheck everything except for primary, which you can't uncheck anyways. And then we're going to click on save. We have now set our email up so that we're using a single inbox instead of multiple inboxes. To stay organized using a single Gmail inbox, we're going to make use of the starred feature, and we're also going to create some labels. But don't worry, I'm going to keep it simple. We essentially want a place to put actionable items that we need to act on as soon as possible, to put emails that we need to read relatively soon, and then just a place to store everything else that we may need to access at a later date. For actionable emails, I like to use the starred feature. So if we take a look at our email, let's say that we have this email here that we need to reply to, say, today or this week. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to open it up in this example. And from here, I'm going to go up to the top, and I'm going to go to the More dropdown, and I'm going to click Add Star. And now I'm going to click the Archive button, which is this button up here at the top left, which is going to take this email out of my inbox. So it's no longer here shown in my inbox, but if I click on this starred section over here on the left, that email will show up. So that's where I like to keep all of my emails that are actionable. Now you can also have both read and unread emails here in the starred section, and you could use that feature to organize the starred emails a little bit and prioritize maybe the unread starred emails over the ones that have been read. But for now, I just want you to get used to using the star feature to put things that are important over there. Personally, I use the starred option for emails that I need to get to this week. For emails that I need to get to today, I actually just leave them in my inbox and usually make them unread as well so that they stay front and center in my inbox. Let's go back to the inbox and let's talk about creating a label for emails that we need to read within the next week or so, but they're not actionable right now. So to do that, we're going to go to the left side of the screen and we're just going to click on the plus button next to where it says labels. And now we can go ahead and give our label a name. We can just call this to read. And I do want to mention real quick that in Gmail, labels function a lot like folders. There is a slight difference, but from our minimalistic point of view, it doesn't really matter. We can look at them as essentially folders in Gmail. So we're going to call this label to read, and then we'll just click create. Now when we do that, you'll notice that on the left side of the screen, we now have our label. And if we hover over it, we can click on these three dots to see some options about this label. So first of all, we can give this label a color, which I recommend. Because it just helps organize things and helps it so you can see things better. There are a few more options in here as well. Generally, if it's a label that I like to access a lot, I like to leave it on show for both of these options, in label list and in message list. That way you just know that the label will always appear here on the left side of the screen. We could also edit the name of the label from here. We could even remove it entirely, and I'll tell you that even if a bunch of emails have that label, if you remove the label, it doesn't delete the emails. So don't be afraid to go in here and play around with labels a little bit. You're not going to be deleting emails by deleting labels and that sort of thing, so don't be afraid of that. And then you could obviously add a sub-label here if you wanted as well. Okay, so now we can go over to our inbox, and we can select all of the emails that we don't need to act on right now, but that we'd like to read later. So you could go through your email on your own and select the ones. I'll just select a few here. Doesn't really matter. Once we have them selected, we're going to go up here to the top, and we have a few different options of how we want to do this. If we want to label them and keep them in the inbox, we can do it from this label section here. However, we can also go over here and click on the Move To folder, and this will move them to the label that we want to move them to, and it will remove them from the inbox at the same time. It essentially labels them and then archives them. That's what it's actually doing on the back end if you want to understand a little bit more about email archiving in Gmail and that sort of thing. But we don't really need to worry about exactly what's happening. Just know that we can either move them, take them out of the inbox and move them to a label, or we could just give them a label without actually moving them out of the inbox. So we want to move them. So I'm going to move them to read. And you'll notice that they are no longer in the inbox. And if we go over here to the to read label, you'll notice that there's a 5 next to it. That means there's 5 unread emails in there. So you'll notice that we have all of the emails that we selected. I could select all of them if I wanted to and make them red so that we no longer have the five over there. But we can go back to our inbox, and then at any time if we need to access these emails, we can access them. And if we want to, say, remove them from the to read list label once we've read them, we can go ahead and we can select them, and we can go back up to the labels and we can uncheck the to read label. Now notice that we have some other labels in here. These are default labels that were created by Gmail. So you can uncheck the updates label if you'd like. It doesn't really matter because it's not showing up here because we're using single inbox. So as far as we're concerned, those pre-created labels don't really matter, but if it bothers you, just uncheck it and apply. And you'll notice that that email is gone. And now it's also gone from our inbox because we archived it. But there are a few ways to access that email, and we'll talk about them here shortly. So go ahead and create some labels that work for you. You could even create some filters that automatically label emails as they come in, but we're going to keep it more simple than that. You could create as many labels as you'd like, but before you get crazy with labels, let me explain why you really don't need them. So first of all, you can use the star feature for actionable emails like we talked about, and you can even put emails in there that you need to read later on or soon, because at the end of the day, a big part of being a minimalist is addressing things so that you can move on. The more labels and folders you have, the more likely you are to put things off for the future instead of dealing with them now. So for actionable emails and emails that you want to read soon, you can use the starred feature. But what about emails that you want to refer to later? Well, just use search. Seriously, I have a bunch of labels created, but I rarely ever use them because the search feature is so powerful in Gmail. You can search by a sender's name. So I could search for Anson and all of the emails with my name come up. You could also search by subject. So if I search for Adobe, all of the Adobe emails are going to come up. You can search by labels, you can search by the title of the email or the body of the email. So at the end of the day, you're going to save more time just searching for these emails when you need them than you are going to be creating labels and then finding the right way to store them and getting your all of your emails organized and then finding the right label to access when you need to find it again. I mean, I'm feeling disorganized just talking about it. So stop it. Just use search. It is so much easier and it's going to save you a lot of time. The next tip for being a Gmail minimalist may seem obvious, but I bet a lot of you have been putting it off and could use just a little bit of a nudge to get moving. Yes, that's right. I'm talking about taking an unsubscribe week or an unsubscribe month or however much time you need to get some breathing room. The way it works is for a week or a month or however long you need, you are actually going to open up all of the emails like this that you usually just delete and say, I'm too lazy to unsubscribe right now, or maybe sometime they'll send me something useful. No, they won't. Stop it. You've got to do this. It's going to free up so much space in your brain for you. You're going to open up the email, you're going to scroll all the way down, and you're going to find the unsubscribe link. If you look for 10 seconds and you can't find it, you're going to go up to the top and you're going to hit report spam. And Gmail will let you know if they have an unsubscribe link. Gmail gives you the option to report spam and unsubscribe. So you could hit that, or you could go back out and say, hey, I don't really want to mark it as spam, but I do want to unsubscribe. So you could go find the link. And if this isn't here, if it doesn't say report spam and unsubscribe, they literally don't have an unsubscribe link. So they absolutely deserve to be reported as spam, and you deserve to no longer receive their emails. So go ahead and report spam and unsubscribe, or just hit the unsubscribe link. And you are going to do this for an entire week or month or however long it takes. And I promise you, it will free up so much clutter in your email and in your brain. I do this about every 6 months or so, and I absolutely love the feeling after that first week or so of my unsubscribe week. I only get emails that I either want or that I need. So the only things that come into my inbox are things that are important, which makes it really easy to either star them or just archive them, which is what we're going to talk about next. Now, since I'm recommending that you reduce your use of labels, I think it's important to be aware of the all mail folder and understand a little bit about how it works. So the all mail folder is where all of your emails go when they come in here to Gmail. The only emails that aren't in the all mail folder are emails that have been deleted or marked as spam. So right now we're in the inbox, but if we go and we click on the all mail folder over here on the left, you'll see that we have all of these emails that are in our inbox. They're labeled inbox. We also have all the emails that we gave the to read label to. And if we were to just go back to our inbox and I were to say, open up an email, if I were to just back out of it, it stays in my inbox, but it's unread. But if I click on it and I archive it, you'll notice that it disappears from the inbox. It's not accessible from a label because we didn't give it a label. But if I go to the all mail folder, there it is. So I do want you to be aware that this is here. Obviously, I recommend that when you're looking for a particular email, you use search. I don't go in the all mail folder very often, but if you've used search and you still can't find what you're looking for, I just want you to be aware that this is where you could go. You could go into the all mail folder and you could just comb through all of your emails that haven't been reported as spam or deleted and try to find the one that you're looking for. By using the starred feature email archiving in Gmail search, you should be able to keep your inbox organized and empty. If an action needs to be taken, give it a star and archive it. If you need to refer to it later, just archive it and then search for it later on. This may not be an advanced tutorial in regards to the features shown, but I hope you found it helpful in its minimalistic approach to staying organized with Gmail. If you did, I would really appreciate a thumbs up here on YouTube if there are specific Gmail features that you would like me to cover more in depth. Please let me know in the comments section below. And if you want to see more technology tips and tutorials like this one, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. That's all I have for you for today. This is Anson from AnsonAlex.com.